Greetings, salutations, fellow hockey fans. The moment we've been waiting for is finally here. It's not March Madness. April Madness? That's not a thing. But in any event, April is here. And it's finally here, which means it's the final full month before the season comes to an end. And of course, for us Uber sports fans, April 1st means baseball's almost on the horizon. To hockey. Oh, what a March, huh? March, even though March was not the home stretch month this year for obvious reasons, it was still pretty exciting. It still had its great moments, and it ended very well for a lot of teams. These guys being one of them. The Sabres finally ended March on a winning note. Honestly, I'm happy for them. They finally ended that terrible, terrible losing streak they had. 18 games. That ties the record. The 03-04 Penguins lost 18 in a row. And then the lockout happened. And then the first season back, they get Crosby. And the rest is history. So April is here. The season is set. Well, the season was originally set to end on May 8th, but because of extra games that had to be played, because they were postponed and moved due to COVID protocols, the latest date at the moment for the end of regular season is May 11th, because some games were recently moved to as late as May 11th, so that's going to be... That looks like it's going to be the actual official end of the regular season, May 11th. But so that leaves 41 days left. And the thing about April being the home stretch month is it's really vital because it's one less day than March. April has 30 days even. We all remember the poem. 30 days have September, April, June, and November, etc., etc., etc. Okay. So we're down to the final 41 days of the regular season. The last full month of the season. This is the month where the contenders and the pretenders are separated. Playoff spots will be clinched during this month. And remember, of course, this year only, top four each division get in. So it's going to make things a little bit easier to figure out. At least it should be. But what's the story entering this pivotal month? Well, I will tell you. First off, we will start with the North, the Canadian Division. Toronto's win over Winnipeg keeps them in first place at 49 points, 23 wins, 23-10-3. Winnipeg's still right behind them, 46 points. Edmonton, 45. So it's pretty much entering the month of April, it's pretty much established who the real top playoff teams are. So that's pretty much going to be your top three. And then currently in fourth place, the pivotal spot, the Canadiens, who came off that break, that COVID break, and shut out the Oilers. So they have 39 points. They lead the Calgary Flames by 4 points. Actually, the Calgary Flames and the Vancouver Canucks by 4 points for that final spot. Calgary and Vancouver, each have 35 points, each have identical records, 16-18-3. But Calgary's ahead because they have more regulation wins, 3 more, 14, than Vancouver, 11. Of course, Ottawa brings up the rear like they've been doing all season. Though they have had some impressive wins, Calgary can't beat them for some reason. That's why they're in this mess. That's why the Flames are in this mess, because Calgary cannot beat the Senators. It's very strange. But anyway, so... Yeah, as far as predictions, the only difference is Winnipeg. I actually did pick the Flames to be in the playoffs, and now I kind of feel kind of silly because the Flames are playing like complete garbage. Okay, so that's the North. The East. The East has been very interesting. Now, the top four I picked in the East has pretty much been where they are. Washington's leading with 50 points. But the Islanders and Pittsburgh are right behind. Islanders and Pittsburgh are right behind them. Islanders and Pittsburgh each have 48 points. They play the same amount of games, but Islanders have more regulation wins. Islanders have 18, Pittsburgh is 16. but the Penguins have been on the road. They won four in a row to end this month. Boston, even with their kind of up and down problems, they're fourth. They're above that playoff line at 18-9-5 with 41 points. Philly is behind it. They're 3 points behind Boston. And what happened in that game? They're the idiots who got blown out 6-1 against a team that hadn't won in a month. That right there is why I didn't pick them to make the playoffs. They have severe problems, especially in goaltending. Everybody scores on them. Hell, I can score on them. It's just pathetic. The Rangers, who have been in Carter Hart's nightmares for a while, have 36 points, so they're kind of getting close. The Devils have 31 points in Buffalo. Congratulations for them for winning, but they're still a hot mess. That was only their seventh win of the season. Yeah, so the East is getting interesting, especially that top three. Well, especially the top three. Washington, Islanders, Pittsburgh are pretty much established as the top three. The fourth, it's not a log jam. I mean, Boston's ahead by 3 points. That's not a lot, but it's something. But as amazing as the East is, the Central, whoo, wow, that is taking a turn. So, the Central. There are four teams in the league right now entering the month of April that have 50 points, that reach 50. Two of them are in the Central, and two of them are in Florida. The Lightning and the Panthers each have 50, but Tampa has the lead because they have a game in hand. Carolina is 49, right behind both teams. So they're gonna be the top three or the four. It's just who's gonna finish where. That's the only thing that needs to be solved. But Tampa, Florida, Carolina, it's pretty much a foregone conclusion that none of them are gonna finish below third. Now here's where the other log jam comes in. Nashville passed the division's playoff line. And it's funny because about a few weeks ago, Nashville was kind of screwed. They were. Nashville was kind of screwed. The Predators were in a bad way. I think they were barely ahead of Dallas and Detroit. But here they are. They went on a winning tear. They won six straight. They won 8 out of 10, including beating Chicago. Chicago can't beat the Predators this year. I think the Blackhawks don't have a win against Nashville. That's why Nashville is above the playoff line. Nashville and Chicago are both tied at 39 points. They play the same number of games, but they have two more regulation wins than Chicago. That's putting them up there. And Chicago was this great story. Because remember, the Blackhawks pretty much admitted after last season ended, remember, that they were rebuilding. And it's funny because the Blackhawks weren't the same team that dominated the 2010s, but they got in that bubble. They were the 12th seed in the Western Conference. They beat out Edmonton. They got crushed by Vegas, but they still went farther than a lot of people thought they would. And that's when they decided to kind of blow it up a bit. They traded Saad. Taze was out for the year. He's still out. Kirby Doc just now came back. But they've been doing it. They've been winning games. And they were above the division's playoff line until very recently. But Chicago still has a chance. And Columbus, they've been kind of struggling a bit too. They have 36 points. They're 3 points behind Nashville and Chicago. And of course, Dallas, Detroit, they're kind of bringing up the rear in that division. Dallas still has a lot of games in hand, but they're still seventh ahead of Detroit, who has been winning games lately. Well, Detroit's been playing the spoiler role pretty well. Who did I pick as the top four? I think I had Tampa, Carolina, Columbus, and Dallas. So this is all messed up. This is all messed up. Because I didn't think Florida would be this good. And I'm kind of happy that they are. Because Florida hasn't had any moment since they went to the Stanley Cup Final. That was 25 years ago. And Nashville and Chicago are kind of big forces. But while Columbus is going down, and Dallas is just playing horribly. Just terrible. Definitely not the same team that made the final last year. And last but not least, the West Division. And guess who's in first place entering the month of April? Boom! Oh my goodness. The Avalanche, 50 points, just got the win, 9-3. Vegas fell to the Kings 4-2. Colorado is leading the West entering the month of April. Colorado with 50, Vegas with 49, Minnesota is in third at 44 because they went on a bit of a winning tear. I think early in the month, I think it kind of started late February. Nobody was beating them except us. And St. Louis is in fourth, barely. They should send us a gift basket. They really should, because Arizona is 1 point behind them, and they had a chance to move past St. Louis, but we decided to shove pucks down their goalies' throats. So, the Blues are welcome. And the Kings have an outside shot at the playoffs. 34 points. The Sharks have 34 points. The Sharks have been kind of playing well as of late. But the Ducks, of course, bring up the rear. They're kind of screwed. It's strange. Now, my predicted top four was Colorado, Vegas, St. Louis, and LA. The big three are up there. That's expected because it was pretty much a foregone conclusion that the Avs, Vegas, and St. Louis would be three of the top four. However, it does look like, from what I'm seeing, St. Louis is not in the same league as Colorado or Vegas. I remember, in the NBA, Chuck Barker used to say about the NBA, Miami Heat's big three, the big two, and Bosch. St. Louis is Bosch. Yeah, the Blues are just playing so horribly. They are. They have not played well at all lately. They've lost 8 of the last 10, and they just can't seem to beat anybody. Hell, even the Ducks have beaten them. That's embarrassing. But Colorado, oh, I am just as happy as a pig in muck at how the Avalanche are playing. A big winning march, a point streak of 12 games. We haven't lost in regulation. We haven't lost in regulation in about what, almost 3 weeks? We're just on a tear. We're playing like that team that's favored to win. Thing is, so is Vegas. So we have 2 games left against Vegas. They're in Vegas. We need to kind of win those and keep winning the others. So here's how this is gonna happen. Here's what's gonna happen. Every Sunday in April, I'll report on the week that was. When teams clinch, I'll congratulate them. There'll be congratulatory clinching videos from teams who make the playoffs. Same with division titles and the President's Trophy, because that's still gonna be a thing. I kind of hope we don't get it because it's jinxed. But and of course, there's no clinching on the horizon already. I mean, it's April 1st. But when it comes to weekly report, I'll be back on YouTube on Sunday to report on the week that was, and what and where things stand. So that's my recap video of the story so far entering this pivotal month. It's gonna be a fun month. It's been a fun short season, and all I'm saying is, well, April's here. Bring on the playoffs. So I'll be back on Sunday. I'll be back on YouTube on Sunday. And with that, I say, until then, and enjoy this home stretch of the hockey season.